Hi friends, this is the first video in a series about virtual machines. In this video we'll go through a simple virtual design which you can set up on a physical machine, which could be a desktop, laptop or a Mac. I'll give you a few options to choose from, but I'll be choosing one of the options myself to continue. This is just a design phase and after that we'll continue with the installation and configuration process. I've created the picture you're seeing here using an online tool called Visual Paradigm. If you're interested, you can find their link in the description. An important part of your virtual lab is documentation, and this tool helps with that. Because we'll be using one physical machine to install multiple virtual machines, we need a fast computer. As a minimum requirement, I would suggest to have at least a 4-core CPU which supports virtualization, something you'll need to look into. 8 GB of RAM, 256 GB of SSD. A normal HDD could also work, but an SSD is recommended due to its speed. This is just for managing 2 or maybe 3 virtual machines, but in order to get a clear picture of the system you'll need, it's best to first design the lab and its purpose to determine what computing resources they'll need. A virtual lab provides a flexibility in configuration without a high hardware cost. It will help you with your IT training path in order to have a safe environment to play in. This way you can erase and restart a virtual machine easily by using snapshots to go back in time, which saves a lot of time. With that, keep in mind that your virtual lab should not be used for personal use, like storing files. Keep your personal files and applications separate. First thing that you'll need to decide is which operating system are you going to focus on. I would recommend to start with Linux CentOS, which is what I'll be using in the next chapters. If you're Windows oriented, you can take that route. I'll be covering Windows later on. Installing macOS as a virtual machine is tricky, and I will not be covering that at this moment. You could of course use macOS as your physical host machine where you'll be installing the virtual machines, but installing macOS as a virtual machine is tricky. There is also the option to rent a cloud server, which depending on the specs will cost between $5 to $10 a month per virtual machine. So depending on how many virtual machines you want to set up, this could get expensive. Working with virtual machines, you'll hear the term hypervisor often. A hypervisor is simply the software that allows the virtual machines to operate. There are 2 types of hypervisors. Type 1 hypervisor is an operating system like ESXi. Type 2 hypervisor is an application which is installed on an operating system like VirtualBox or VMware. Type 1 hypervisors are best suited for a lab because the resources are best used by virtual machines. On a Type 2 hypervisor, the VMs are competing for resources with your physical machine. But Type 2 hypervisors are easier to set up, especially when you only have 1 physical machine to work on. We'll be using Type 2 hypervisor VirtualBox, but later I'll be trying to cover Type 1 hypervisors in a future video. For your virtual lab, it's best to configure a separate router with separate Wi-Fi connection to limit affecting other devices at home. Limiting the Wi-Fi broadcast power is also a good practice to reduce the Wi-Fi coverage, security risks, and competing with other Wi-Fi broadcasts on the same bandwidth. Configuring DHCP, for example, could easily have an impact on your devices if they use the same router. But if you don't need to configure those type of services, then you can use the same router. One way to configure your VMs automatically is to use configuration management tools like Puppet and Ansible. I'll try to cover those in a future video. I just decided to restart my YouTube channel, and if you're interested in how I did that, then watch my previous video. In the next video, I'll go through the installation steps of a few VMs using a MacBook running VirtualBox. See you then.